करुणालयम् नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओं सहना भवतु सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। गोब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं एतादृश्चक्रणोति तस्मै तं देवमात्मूर्ति प्रकाशं मुक्षुरु वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे दुर्ख्यत्त निर्मल पारं सर्वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेवाहन्न मत्तोन्य दिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। She had given an example as to jnana karma samuchaya or upasana and karma on one side as a wing of a bird, the other wing being jnana. So samuchayavadi says that just like a pakshi cannot fly without the two pakshas, similarly one cannot get moksha without karma upasana backing the jnana. Also for jnana rakshana karma is needed. Jnana sadhana karma is also sadhana for moksha. So in various ways he has expressed that karma upasana cannot be dropped off for moksha. The example given about the pakshi, akashe pakshi patana drishtanta atra na yujyate, that is not applicable here, says the siddhanti. Why so? Pakshino dvavapi pakshau ekakale eva staha. The bird has both the wings simultaneously. Tasmanna tayov paraspara virodha. The virodha which has been shown of the jnana with karma or upasana, that is because parokshatvam, aparokshatvam are not opposed to each other. But aparoksha jnana and aparoksha ajnana are opposed to each other. Similarly, the karya of ajnana will also be opposed to by this aparoksha jnana. Thereby, we had seen that atascha jnanasya upasanasya cha virodha or karmanaha cha virodha. Also, we had seen that this is the reason vidushaha karmadhikaraha nasti, vidushaha karmadhikara nasti due to multiple reasons. We had seen that ashrama, jati ashrama, varna ashrama, all these do not apply to the vidwan. So virodha is there between jnana and ajnana. Thereby ajnana karya also being of the same characteristics as ajnana has opposition from jnana. So jnanasya karmopasanabhyam virodha asti, whereas the pakshi example there paraspara paksha virodha nasti. One wing is not opposed to the other, so they can go in sync together, just like aparoksha jnana and paroksha jnana can be simultaneous. Paroksha jnana with respect to the shastra janya jnana. Shastra janya jnana is that you are atma. For a karmi, karta bhokta atma, which is different from the sharira. This is paroksha jnana. And in the deha, there is tadatmya sambandha. Deha considered as oneself, deha dharma is considered as oneself, are all aparokshataya. So aparoksha jnana and paroksha jnana do not have any contradiction to each other. Like the two wings of the bird, they can be together. But jnanasya karma upasana abhyam virodha asti. Jnana, which is this advaita jnana, there is virodha with the karma and upasana, because jnana aparoksha jnana will have opposition to aparoksha jnana. तस्माद् एककालावस्थानं न तयो संभवति. वंस द अपरोक्ष ज्ञान अराइजेस देन कर्मोपासना विचार अज्ञान कार्य विच इज अपरोक्ष अज्ञान विल बी काउंटर्ड. दे आर नॉट एग्जिस्टेंट एट ऑल टुगेदर, देयरफॉर दिस कर्मोपासना इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी पॉसिबल व्हेन अज्ञान इटसेल्फ इज इन देयर विच इज द बेसिस फॉर कर्म एंड उपासना. तस्माद् एककाल अवस्थानं न तयो संभवति. कर्म एंड ज्ञान कैनॉट बी टुगेदर. मोक्षम उद्देश्य ज्ञान से कर्म उपासनयोर अपेक्षा भाव. मोक्षम उद्देश्य, इफ द गोल इज मोक्ष देन कंसिडरिंग मोक्ष एज लक्ष्य. ज्ञान ज्ञान से कर्म उपासनयोर अपेक्षा भाव. ज्ञान डज नॉट हैव कर्म एंड उपासना अपेक्षा ऑल्सो. इफ मोक्ष इज द गोल, इट इज नीडेड फॉर ज्ञान साधना बट नॉट फॉर मोक्ष इटसेल्फ, बिकॉज ज्ञान बाय इटसेल्फ विल लीड टू मोक्ष. सो सेतु दर्शन दृष्टांत वाज गिवन, अनदर एग्जांपल गिवन बाय द पूर्व पक्षी कर्मी वाज दैट सेतु दर्शन बाय इटसेल्फ इजंट सफिशियंट फॉर द पापनाश. ऑल्दो सेतु दर्शन इज नीडेड but by itself isn't sufficient. There is a dependency of shraddha, shastreshu shraddha. And the other dependencies may also be there. Just setu darshana will not bring papanasha, although it is prescribed by the shastra. So that example is not valid here. It is out of place. Why so? मोक्षं प्रति ज्ञानस्य कर्मोपासनयो सह सहाय्य विषये प्रदर्शितः सेतुदर्शन दृष्टांत न संगच्छते. दैट सेतुदर्शन दृष्टांत सो इज मेंशनड हियर इज दैट रावण वधाय लंकां गन्तुं श्री रामचंद्रेण रामेश्वरम आरभ्य लंका पर्यन्तं समुद्रे सेतुर्वद्धः. सो अत्र सेतुर्विवक्षितः, दैट इज द सेतु रामसेतु विच गोस फ्रॉम रामेश्वर टू लंका. दैट इज प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर पापनाश. मोक्षं प्रति ज्ञानस्य कर्मोपासनयो साहाय्य विषये प्रदर्शित सेतु दर्शन दृष्टांत न संगच्छते. दैट दृष्टांत इज नॉट वैलिड हियर, दैट एग्जांपल गिवन बाय पूर्व पक्षी. वाय सो सेतु दर्शनम न दृष्टफलस्य हेतुः, किंतु अदृष्टफलस्य एव हेतुः. The result that Setu Darshana brings in is Adrishta. It is not Aparoksha to the Karmi. One who has Setu Darshana, the Setu Drashta, will not have Anubhava of Papanasha. It is not Pratyaksha to him. So it is Adrishta Phala, not Drishta Phala. So Drishta Phala Hetu isn't Setu Darshana. इट इज अदृष्ट फल हेतु. यत् फलं प्रत्यक्षेण प्रतीयते तत् फलं प्रत्यक्ष फलम् इत्युच्यते. यथा भोजनस्य फलभूता तृप्तिः प्रत्यक्षात् तद्वत्. जस्ट लाइक ईटिंग फूड ब्रिंग्स तृप्ति, इट इज अ दृष्ट फल प्रत्यक्ष अपरोक्ष टू दि भोजनकर्ता भोक्ता. सिमिलरली दिस सेतु दर्शन इज नॉट ब्रिंगिंग दृष्ट फल. तस्मात् भोजनं दृष्टफलस्य हेतु. सो भोजन गिव्स यू अपरोक्ष तृप्ति, देयर बाय इट इज दृष्टफल हेतु. दैट तृप्ति इज दृष्टफल. तथा सेतु दर्शनेन किञ्चिदपि प्रत्यक्षं फलं प्रतीयते, किंतु पापस्य नाशरूपं फलं शास्त्रेण अधिगम्यते. वी नो दिस इज ट्रू बिकॉज शास्त्र सेज सो. देयर विल बी पापनाश ऑन सेतु दर्शन, एंड आफ्टर हैविंग सेतु दर्शन यू विल assume that you will get that phala because it is guaranteed by the shastra. Papa nasha will take place. Yat pratyakshena na pratiyate tad adrushta phalam ityuchyate, and that is adrushta phala because pratyakshataya you have not seen papa go away on setu darshana. Tasmad yatha yajnyadi karma swargad yadrushta phalasya hetu, tatha setu darshanam api papa nasha rupa adrushta phalasya hetu. Yaha adrushta phala hetu tasya swaphalotpadane यावती सामग्री सहायतः तया शास्त्रेण चोद्यते तावत्या सामग्र्या सहित एव सफलस्य हेतुर्भवति. So there is a limitation now. This adrushta phala, just like yajnyadi karma, is going to lead to swargadi adrushta phala by becoming a hetu. Similarly, this hetu darshana will also be papa nasha rupa adrushta phalasya hetuhu. However, yaha adrushta phala hetuhu, that karma, upasana, whatever that brings adrushta phala, tasya swaphalotpadane yavati samagri sahayataya shastrena chodyate. The dependency that you are talking about for the setu darshana in this example, that dependency of samagri, shraddha ityadi, is needed for setu darshana to effect papanasha. It is limited to, and it is mandatory to have these dependent sadhanas for setu darshana to give the result of papanasha. Tavatya samagriya sahita eva sa phalasya hetur bhavati. By itself it is not the hetu at all. Setu darshana is not the hetu for papanasha. If papanasha has to take place, then the samagris which are there, shraddha ityadi in shastra, along with the setu darshana, together they become the hetu for adrushta phala utpatti, papanasha. Natu kevalaha hetur bhavati. So this by itself, it is not papanasha hetu. Ataiva shraddha niyamadi sahitameva setu darshanam papanasha rupa phala hetuhu. So shraddha, niyama, all these are to be followed as given in the scriptures. Together they are samagri for papanasha. Together they are hetu for papanasha. Samagri sahita. Karma. So karma is samagri sahita. Setu darshanena pratyaksham kimapi phalam na drushyate, kevalam shastra tat phalam avagamyate. You know only through shastra that setu darshana is going to give you papanasha. Shastram cha shraddha niyamadi sahitameva setu darshanam papanashakam ityah, kevala setu darshana phalotpattau na kinchidapi pramanam asti. So for you to say that setu darshana will lead to papanasha but has expectancy, that is because it is not the hetu at all. You are taking one as a hetu and bringing the two dependencies, but all put together are the hetu for papanasha as per the shastra. You don't know that setu darshana is a papanasha hetu. You know it only through shastra. There is no other pramana for this. Tasmat setu darshanam swaphalotpattau shraddha bhakti niyamadikam apekshate. There is already an apeksha sitting in. That is not applicable in the exemplified, where I am saying jnana is said to be moksha hetu by shastra, and we see this applicable in ajnana nivritti in other places. So logically also we have pramana that jnana is ajnana nasha hetu. By itself, there is no dependency at all on anything. So if you bring in karma upasana, that is not valid at all. The example is out of place, because here on one side in the example, you have multiple things together which become a hetu for the result. And in the exemplified, you have one which leads to result. The dependencies cannot be brought in at all. The dependencies can be argued upon on their own merits. Karma and upasana merits can be brought in, jnana merits can be compared, and then you can argue. But you cannot bring in an example where there is hetu of multiple things together. Here there is no hetu given as multiple things are needed together. So prama, this example, this drishtanta is out of place. That is pointed out. Now jnana phalasya mokshasya nitya praptatvat jnanasya karma upasana apeksha abhavaha. Whereas this ज्ञान फल मोक्ष इज ऑल्सो नॉट अटेनेबल द वे दी अदृष्टा इज अटेनेबल. अदृष्टा इज उत्पन्न ऑन सेतु दर्शन. दिस इज द अदर रीजन व्हाई कंपैरिजन इज नॉट पॉसिबल, बिकॉज मोक्ष इज ऑलरेडी सिद्ध. इट इज प्राप्तस्य प्राप्ति. देर इज नो उत्पत्ति ऑफ एनी फल पर से. तमो निवृत्तौ दीप प्रभावत स्वपरोत्पत्तौ ब्रह्म विद्या कर्मोपासने न अपेक्षते नावेक्षते. बोथ शुड बी ओके. सो वी कांट सी दैट देयर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी देयर. ब्रह्म विद्या डज नॉट एक्सपेक्ट कर्म एंड उपासना. जस्ट लाइक तमो निवृत्तौ दीप प्रभावत. सो दिस दीप प्रभा द लाइट ऑफ द लैम्प takes away tamas. Now this is its own result. When you light a lamp, the lamp by its very nature takes away darkness that is surrounding. That is its own phala. Does it depend on anything else? It does not depend on anything else. Similarly, Brahma Vidya by very nature will take away Brahma Avidya. The locus in which Vidya works, in that locus, if there is avidya, it will take away that avidya. This is the very nature of any Vidya. So, Brahma Vidya does not have any expectancy of karma and upasana. Brahma Vidyaya phalam api swargadi vad yadi loka vishesha rupa adrishta phalam syat yadi cha shastram tasya loka visheshasya kevala Brahma Vidyaya अप्राप्यत्वं कर्मोपासन सहित आई थिंक तकार इज रिपीटेड बाय एरर. कर्मोपासन सहित ब्रह्म विद्या प्राप्यत्वं च बोधयेत् तदा ब्रह्म विद्यापि सेतु दर्शनवत् स्वफलोत्पत्तौ कर्मोपासने अपेक्षेते. सो कर्मोपासने अपेक्षेत. So it's an Atmanepadi. So there would be possibility of dependency only if Shastra would talk about it, that Brahma Vidya has dependency on karma and upasana. It doesn't talk about it. Why? Because it is not adrushta phala. It is not adrushta which is janya, the way it is janya on karma and upasana being done. So if the Brahma Vidya phala was like Swargadi phala, where adrishta is utpanna on karma and upasana being done, similarly if you do something and then jnana is utpanna, jnana brings this moksha as adrishta phala which is utpanna, then your point would be valid, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. But it is not loka vishesha rupa adrushta phalam. Moksha is not like that. Yadi cha shastram tasya loka visheshasya kevala brahma vidyaya apraapyatvam bodhayet. If shastra were to reveal that kevala brahma vidya cannot lead to moksha, which is this loka, loka vishesha, brahma loka ityadi. But Shastra does not talk about moksha as something which is utpanna or to be attained in different loka. It is your own swarupa. Then if it were to talk about it, or it would, if the Shastra were to talk about dependencies also, then your point is, would be valid. But it is not so. So karma upasana sahita Brahmavidya prapyatvancha bodhayet. If Shastra were to talk about these two things of dependency of Brahmavidya on something else, or kevala Brahmavidya cannot give you this result of moksha. If any, actually, if both or any of these statements were to be made by Shastra, then your objection would be valid, or your expression of dependency of Brahmavidya to get moksha on karma and upasana would be valid. Nahi brahma vidya phala rupah moksha swargadivat लोक विशेष रूप अदृष्ट फलम किंतु मोक्षः नित्य प्राप्त वी हैव सीन दिस आत्मस्वरूप इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज मोक्ष इट इज नित्य प्राप्त इट इज नॉट रिजल्ट लाइक स्वर्गादि फल बंधस्तु भ्रांत्या प्रतीयते बंध इज ड्यू टू अज्ञान एंड देयरफॉर इट इज अ डिल्यूजन तस्या भ्रांते हे निवृत्ति रेव ब्रह्म विद्याया फलम सो दैट भ्रांति निवृत्ति इज फल व्हाट इज दैट फल इट इज फलवत फल बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी स्वतः सिद्ध स्वरूप ऑफ आत्मा केवलया ब्रह्म विद्याया तस्याः भ्रांते हे निवृत्तिर अस्माकं प्रत्यक्षा ब्रह्मविदां ज्ञानिनां अस्माकं इज फॉर अस हु आर ब्रह्मविद Who are jnanis, for us it is pratyaksha. What is pratyaksha? That kevala brahma vidya leads to bhranti nivrutti, dvaita bhranti nivrutti, bandha bhranti nivrutti. Rajju jnana sarpa bhrantir nivruttir yatha sarvesham pratyaksha tadvada. Just like for all of you, says the Siddhanti, how sarpa jnana is a bhranti, And Rajju Jnana brings about this Bhranti Nivrutti by itself without any dependency on anything else. Similarly, for Brahma Jnanis, for us he says, who are Brahma Jnani, for us it is very clear that Kevala Brahma Vidya leads to Moksha. Tasmad Adhishthana Jnanasya Phalam Bhranti Nivrutti Rupam Drishtam Eva Phalam. This is not Adrishta Phala, it is Drishta Phala, it is Pratyaksha, it is Aparoksha. And In this case, there is no dependency possible. Drishtaphalasya utpatti yavatya samagriya sadhyataya pratyakshena pratiyate tavati samagri drishtaphalasya heturityuchyate yatha turitantu vemadibhi patasya utpatti pratyaksha iti turitantu vemadikam patasya hetuhu. So, drishtaphala hetu Here it is drishta phala hetu. Moksha is drishta phala, drishtameva phalam, and what is it? Bhranti nivrutti rupa. So dvaita bhranti, bandha bhranti, nivrutti rupa, moksha, that is drishta phala. And what is drishta phala? Drishta phala hetu, what is called as drishta phala hetu? Drishta phalasya utpatti hi yavatya samagriya sadhyatya sadhyataya pratyakshena pratiyate. There is a typo here. It is should be, it should not be joined to takara. It is sadhyataya. This is right. Samagrya. But sadhyataya. Because pratipadika sadhyata. Here it is samagri. So yakara will be, in third case you will get samagrya. Nadyavata. Here ramaya. What you will get sadhyataya. So, drishtaphalasya utpatti yavatya samagriya sadhyataya pratyakshena pratiyate tavati samagri drishtaphalasya heturityuchyate. Sadhya sadhana bhava, if it is there, then as much is the sadhana needed, not anything more than that. As much is the samagri needed as sadhana to attain the sadhya, only that much should be considered. As hetu for drishta phala. So sadhyataya pratyakshena pratiyate and you should not put in other things logically it appears so. Not logically, pratyaksha, I know that this is sufficient to get the drishta phala. That much samagri pratiti is there. Nothing more than that. Pratyaksha, it should be clear to me. Not because someone else says that this is needed, that is needed. That is why he said that asmakam jnani naam. यथा तुरीतंतु वेमादिभि पटस्य उत्पत्ति प्रत्यक्षा इति तुरीतंतु वेमादिकं पटस्य हेतु नाउ सो देयर आर यू नो टू मेक अ क्लॉथ व्हाटएवर इज द बेयर मिनिमम नेसेसरी यू पुट यू वीव अ क्लॉथ यू नीड थ्रेड यू नीड नीडल्स यू नीड अ बंडल ऑफ थ्रेड और यू नो यू नीड दीज हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड वर्टिकल The machines which will put the threads together in a pattern, horizontally and vertically. So, all these are considered as hetu for the tantu, the cloth. So actually here it is in the case of not the patasya utpatti turi tantu. So tantu is a thread and the other which will put that tantu in a particular order to make a cloth. So patasya utpatti pratyakshat, and when you do that you know that the cloth is formed. Pratyakshataya, so you know samagri directly, you don't need someone else to tell you that, oh no, this cloth has come about with something else that you don't know about. Now you cannot bring in things such as whoever, you know, watered the cotton tree there. So you have brought in cotton and from cotton the thread has been made. So tantu has come about from cotton. Now you cannot argue that the person who planted the tree, who watered the plant, who plucked the the cotton seeds and stuff like that, all this is irrelevant. This is not pratyaksha to me. To me, what is the sakshat sadhana for pata? Whatever samagri I have pratyakshataya, it is samagri for tantu, that is the sadhana. So sadhana sadhya bhava is only between these. Everything else you cannot talk about. What is pratyaksha, that itself is drishtaphalasya hetuhu. यथा च केवल भोजनेन तृप्ति रूपं फलं प्रत्यक्षम् इति केवल भोजनमेव तृप्ति हेतु. I eat food and I am satisfied. Now you cannot bring in other things there as to know what else has brought me satisfaction of this hunger has been satiated. You cannot bring in any other thing as an input to that. I am very clear that I have eaten food. This is the reason that I crave for food again. And I am able to link even if somebody doesn't teach me. Animals are not taught that eating food will take away your hunger. Logically also, the instinctively and logically also, the animal has enough buddhi. Instinct is developed up to that extent. The buddhi is developed up to that extent that it can infer that if I eat food, it will satiate my hunger. It will bring in satisfaction just like yesterday or this morning. Even the animal knows. It is pratyaksha to the animal also. You cannot explain logic that what else is there. Nothing else is needed. Animal just needs to eat the food. Similarly, I need to eat the food. Similarly, for drishtaphala, whatever is pratyaksha to me, that is the sadhana. Nothing else is needed. यथा वा केवल अधिष्ठान ज्ञानात् भ्रांति निवृत्ति प्रत्यक्षेण प्रतीयत इति अधिष्ठान ज्ञानमेव भ्रांति निवृत्ति भ्रांति निवृत्ते हेतुः. सो भ्रांति निवृत्ति हेतु, व्हाट इज द भ्रांति निवृत्ति हेतु? इन द केस ऑफ रज्जु सर्प, रज्जु ज्ञान, अधिष्ठान रज्जु ज्ञान, एंड दिस इज वेरी क्लियर टू मी. आई डोंट नीड एनीथिंग एल्स. आई डोंट नीड अ स्टिक. सो फॉर यू टू से दैट नो, once I tell you this is Rajju, you start beating the sarpa with the stick, then it will go away. That is useless. So whatever is pratyaksha to me, that much alone, whichever samagri is pratyaksha to me as leading to bhranti nivritti, that much alone is the sadhana for that sadhya phala, drishta phala. With these examples, many examples, so you, no doubts can remain. So that is the process in Vichara Sagara. So it is quite elaborate. Even if we understood, we'll, more examples don't do much harm. It may take a little more time, but we can go fast as well. Yatha rajju jnanam bhranti nivrutto na anyad apekshate tatha bandha bhrantir adishthana bhuta nitya muktatma jnanam api bandha bhranti nivrutto karma upasane na apekshate. Similarly is the case of jnana also, because bandha is bhranti just like sarpa bhranti in rajju. Rajju jnana alone takes away sarpa bhranti. So for sarpa bhranti nivritti, rajju jnana, adhisthana rajju jnana is sufficient. Similarly, bandha bhranti will go away only by adhisthana bhuta nitya mukta atma jnana. Bandha bhranti nivrutto karma upasane na apekshate. It does not have any expectancy of karma and upasana, just like nothing else is expected other than rajju adhisthana, adhisthana bhuta rajju jnana in the case of sarpa bhranti nivrutti. Now, why so much of elaboration in the Karma Upasana section? Why so much of elaboration and refutation in Bhashyas also? You see this coming up again and again, because even if it is repetition, so much repetition is there, but if you look at our nature, human nature is to fall back on karma. I will achieve this. Free will is what drives a person to do something or other, that I am going to attain this. This will apply in the case of moksha also. Even if it is taught so many times, hammered in by the Bhashya, Acharya, Shastra, what have you, still we keep on doing the same things again and again and again and again endlessly. This is the reason that so many examples are given to drive home the point that someday it will click, not in understanding alone, but in behavior also. Because this has to be taken to culmination. You cannot say that, okay, I understand it, and then walk out on it. So we have to follow through. This following through is not happening in many cases, because it has been said that karma and jnana cannot have samuchya. What does it mean? What we are doing, if we inquire into it, it is not resulting in phala, because we are trying to do karma jnana samuchaya. So over and over, this is driven home in each and every work, in each and every bhashya, tika, vartika, whatever you have, each of the places you will have karma jnana samuchaya khandana. Kevalam jnanam eva moksha sadhanam iti shastra vachanam api. And shastra also says that logically it doesn't stand scrutiny, and shastra shraddha, if the purvapakshi has, then he has to be shown that you are violating the shastra rules by applying shushka tarka. Shastra says that kevala jnana eva moksha sadhanam. Earlier case, it has been shown that shastra does not say that kevala jnana will not lead to moksha. It does not say that karma and upasana are dependencies, subsidiaries, or part of the jnana to reach this goal of moksha. And now it is being said that kevalam jnanam eva moksha sadhanam iti shastra vachanam. Shastra, on the other hand, says that kevala jnana will lead to this moksha rupa phala, which is praptasya prapti. Jnana phalasya mokshasya swargadival loka visheshatva varnanena adrishta rupatva angikare vedavakya virodha syat. If somebody says that, like, swargadi lokas are attainable, similarly, jnana phala moksha is attainable, and by comparing, one says that adrushta, moksha is adrushta, that is not true. Moksha is drushta phala, that is why jivan mukti is possible. It is not krama mukti which is compared. Krama mukti is adrushta right now, but jivan mukti is not adrushta, it is drushta rupa phala, it is pratyaksha, it is aparoksha to the jnani. And it is true in the case of any other jnana also. If someone tells you that you have not understood something and you have understood, you may not be able to put it across, but you know that you have no doubt, you have clear understanding of something, then the way it is pratyaksha to you, you know that you have understood. You know that you have not understood. So you are the only pramana there. No other pramana is expected in the case of jnana. Jnana is swatasiddha. Once jnana is uppanna, then in whichever adhikarana there is uppatti, there itself you see that ajnana has gone away. So it is pratyaksha to you. Nobody else can tell you that you don't have jnana. So gradations may vary in the case of laukika jnana. So if someone says that you do not know enough Sanskrit to make this statement, that is possible, but whether or not you have understood something said by the other, basic words, that jnana is very clear to you, whether it is utpanna or not. And there is no other dependency on anything else. So jnana phalasya mokshasya swargadi val loka visheshatva varnanena adrishta rupatvangi kari veda vakya virodhasya. The Purvapakshi insisting that this adrishta phala moksha like swargadi loka is making a statement against the scriptures. Na tasya prana utkramanti brahmaiva san brahma brahma pyeti. So brahma eva san, this jivan mukta jnani, being brahma attains brahma. So praptasya prapti muktascha vimuchyate, vimuktascha vimuchyate. One who is free is freed. What does it mean? There is no real freedom because there was no real bondage. Bandha was mithya, so bandha going away is also mithya. It was never there to go away. So one who was already free knows that he is free, so he is as though freed, as if freed. And what is the resultant though? That result is felt real because prana tasya jnaninaha na utkramanti. Jivan muktasya jnaninaha prana na utkramanti. This is Vidhya Mukti statement though. Brahma eva san, he was always Brahma, he remains Brahma, but when the body drops off, then the prana does not carry the jnani jiva. Antakkarana withers away there itself in its ingredients, in its samagri. It is destroyed. Anadi antakkarana, which limited this jiva as jiva, brahma as jivatma, that limitation was not real, but still there was a bhranti of limitation because antakkarana was limiting. It was setting boundaries. This antakkarana was always there, and across kalpas, across janmas, across kalpas, it was continuing. And across lokas also, this antakkarana was carried with the association of that jivatma based on the karma and upasana that the person had done. So prana was carrying and driving this antakkarana to various lokas, being in the sukshma sharira itself. Now, all that is reversed into its own karana. This is what the Shruti says. Atra brahma samushnate. One attains brahma here and now. There is no travel involved. There is no videha mukti also expected. Jivan mukta attains it then and there. Ityadi shrutayaha jnanina prana na kamapi lokam gacchanti iti varnayanti. So jnani does not have to go elsewhere. It is not krama mukti, it is jivan mukti. Mokshasya loka vishesha rupatvangikare swargadivan mokshah anityah syat. If there is travel involved, that travel itself tells you that there is bheda. Anything that can be reached will not remain in time. Anything that is different from you will always be different. There will be limitation, and limitation means that it is not ananta moksha, it is antavat moksha, antavan moksha, and it is anitya. Mokshasya loka vishesha rupatvangikare api kevala jnani neva moksha prapti rangi kartavya. Now, if someone says that it is a loka anubhava to be attained, lokyate iti loka tells you that it is anubhava also. Whether you travel elsewhere or it is an anubhava to be attained, if it is something like that, even in that case, kevala jnana should be accepted as leading to that anubhava. So, Tippanakara says there, tushyatu durjana iti nyayena siddhanti mokshasya loka vishesha rupatvangikare api sa jnanam vina na siddhyati tyah. So this is hypothesis. This tushyatu durjana is let this Purvapakshi also be happy. Let us analyze his viewpoint. So you suppose that it is true and then you refute it. So that is called as tushyatu durjana nyaya. So jnanam vina na siddhyati, even in that case, moksha being loka vishesha rupa प्राप्ति इन दैट केस आल्सो ज्ञानम विना न सिद्ध्यति दुर्बल पुरुष प्रबल से स्वशत्रो प्रथम स्वप्रहार प्रति अवकाशम दत्वा पश्चात तम मारयति एष एव दुर्जन तोष न्याय इत्युच्यते सो यू नो इन अ फाइट you know that you are going to win so you give the opponent a chance first and then you win over so I don't think it has been expressed in a right manner this is what I think there may be something erroneous here but what it is saying is that if you are fighting us here it is said that purusha prabalasya swashatru but I think it is said in a opposite manner here this is what I think The Nyaya says that just like somebody who is weak, you give that person an opportunity to fight. You know, that is the entertainment in the fight. And then the stronger one wins over. First, you give the chance to the weaker one, whether what is he going to do. So, this is the idea and logically weak. This is a logically weak stance. So, you accept it. Okay, let me see your viewpoint. शास्त्र प्रतिपादितः अर्थः शास्त्रानुसारेण एव अंगीकर्तव्यः इफ द शास्त्र हैज टोल्ड यू द साधना देन यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट द वे शास्त्र हैज सेड यू कैन नॉट ऐड एनीथिंग ऑन योर ओन यू कैन नॉट रिमूव एनीथिंग ऑन योर यू कैन नॉट मेक चेंजेस ऑन योर ओन शास्त्र इज द ओनली प्रमाण देयर शास्त्रं च मोक्षः केवल ज्ञानेन अवाप्यते इति आह शास्त्र सेज दैट ज्ञान अलोन लीड्स टू मोक्ष If you say loka visheshatva prapti rupa moksha also, there also jnana has to be accepted because Shastra says so. You have misunderstood moksha as attainable, as real prapti, as travel being involved, as any kind of moksha that you have misinterpreted. Even in that case, jnana should be accepted as sadhana and that jnana is kevala jnana. Why so? Because Upanishads talk about it. विद्यते हृदय ग्रंथि छिद्यन्ते सर्व संशया क्षीयन्ते चास्य कर्माणि तस्मिन् दृष्टे परावरे यदा चर्मवदाकाशं वीष्टयिष्यन्ति मानवाः तदा देवम् अविज्ञाय दुःखस्यान्तौ भविष्यति तमेव विदित्वाति मृत्युमेति तरति शोकमात्मवे तमेवं विद्वान् अमृतह्य भवति इति ज्ञात्वा देवम् उच्यते सर्वपाशैः ज्ञात्वा देवं सर्वपाशापहानिः इति There are so many Shrutis and Smritis which talk about it. Vidyate hridaya granthihi. Chidyante sarva samshaya akshiyante cha asya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. So this darshana, atma darshana is jnana. It is cognition. So it is jnana. So however you misinterpret jnana, interpret and we'll say misinterpret. But let's say however you interpret moksha, Jnana has to be accepted as sadhana. Nothing. Actually, bhidyate hridaya granthi chidyante sarva samshaya is possible only when the atma darshana takes place. And darshana, how does darshana take place? Atma va re drashtavyaha. That is atma darshana. That is moksha sadhana. And what is the sadhana to that? Shrotavyaha. मंतव्यः निदिध्यासितव्यः सो श्रोतव्यो मंतव्यः निदिध्यासितव्यः दिस हैज बीन सेड एज साधना फॉर आत्मा वा रे द्रष्टव्यः हाउ विल इज आत्मा गोइंग टू बी सीन इट इज नॉट सीइंग लाइक सीइंग समथिंग एल्स बिकॉज इट इज दिस वेरी स्वरूप ऑफ द सीयर सो हाउ शुड इट बी सीन सीइंग इज कंपेरेबल इट इज showing the aparokshatvam. You should have aparoksha jnana of atma. How? Shrotavyo mantavyo nididhyasitavyah. So, atma va are drashtavyah kartavyataya darshanam. That atma darshanam kartavyataya is only through shravana manana nididhyasana. That is not karma really. It is not prescribed karma the way it is in karma and upasana section of karma kanda what will be the result hridaya granthi will be shattered and all samshayas will also be cut asunder or rather hridaya granthi will be cut asunder and the doubts will be shattered. What karma remains then? No karma will remain. Yada charmod akasham veshtayishyanti manavaha. Can akasha be rolled up like a carpet? It cannot be. So anyway, this reminds me, Revati Amma had mentioned that earlier I was not able to make sense of the example of that the milk. A few classes back, we had seen the example of Nisheda of Gokshira. The milk, cow's milk, is Amruta, considered as good for Shastra, has a vidhi of using cow's milk. But that Gokshira, when it is in the dog's hide, a bag made of the dog's leather, it is Nishiddha. So there I was not sure of that word, which means the bag made of the dog's hide, not inside the dog. So anyway, so I just wanted to talk about that. This Charmavad triggered that memory. So yada charmavad akasham veshte ishyanti manava. So veshte, if humans could roll the akasha like a carpet, then tada devam avidyaya dukkhasya antaha bhavishyati. Then alone, through anything else, karma and upasana, would this dukkhanta, dukkha nivritti, atyantika dukkha nivritti would be possible. This is kaimutika nyaya. Basically, it is being said, it is a rhetoric which says that it is impossible through karma and upasana. Devam avijnaya, without jnana, it is not possible. This deva is chaitanya. Jyotana rupa, chaitanya, prakasha rupa, atma. That chaitanya, without knowing that chaitanya, dukkha nivritti, would be possible if it is possible to roll up the akasha. Meaning, akasha rolling up isn't possible. Similarly, without knowing, there is no dukkha nivritti possible. And having known tameva viditva atimrityumeti, one gets that kind of amruta immortality. One attains that, goes beyond mrityu. Tarati shokamatmavet, one crosses over the shoka grief by atmajnana. Tameva vidvan amruta iha bhavati. So one becomes amrutaha vidvan. Who is that vidvan? So one who has vidya. Thereby jnana is expected. Even if you see moksha in any other way, you interpret moksha as loka prapti also, so it will still be jnana. Jnatva deva muchyate sarva pashaihi. One will be freed by all pashas, all kinds of nooses, all kinds of traps by devam jnatva, only having known this chaitanya rupa jnana. Jnatva devam sarva pasha pahanihi iti. There are so many statements in the shastra. So whatever the Purvapakshi considers moksha as, although we do not agree with him, we are telling him that jnana is the only expected sadhana there in any kind of moksha that you think about, because shastra says kevala jnanena mukti or moksha. Tasmat kevalam jnana moksha hetuhu. Karma upasana jnanani trinina moksha karanani. So it has been established that karma and upasana along with jnana, all three are not moksha karana, the way he has talked about as given examples, whether it is Setu Darshana or the earlier Darshana, that is not applicable here. Kevala Jnana is Moksha Hetu. Karma Upasane Jnanasya Sadhane Na Mokshasya. So what is Karma Upasana needed for? It is not that Karma Upasana is not needed at all. It is Sadhana for Jnana, not for Moksha. So Karma Upasana are definitely needed, because we are Vaidikas. Without Karma Upasana, there is no possibility of Chitta Shuddhi. So Vriksha Drishtanta Api Asangataha. He had given a Vriksha Drishtanta also. What was that? Just like Vriksha, to grow for its Utpatti also, from a seed, there is watering needed. That Jalasechana is the Hetu for Vriksha Utpatti, as well as Vriksha Phala Utpatti. So if you say Moksha is Jnana Phala, not Karma Upasana Phala, but Jnana is Karma Upasana Phala, or Karma Upasana is Sadhana for Jnana, but not sadhana for moksha, but for moksha jnana is sadhana, then the example of the Purvapakshi is very brilliant. He had given an example saying that without watering the seed, you wouldn't have got a tree. The phala that you want in the vriksha, that vriksha phala wouldn't have been there had there not been jalasechana. So jalasechana is the hetu not only for vriksha utpatti but also vriksha phala utpatti. Similarly, you have to accept that jnana phala moksha is utpanna due to jnana being utpanna, and jnana is utpanna only because there is jalasechana in the form of this jnana rupa vriksha is utpanna in the due to this jalasechana rupa karma upasana. Thereby karma upasana or sadhana not only for jnana but also for jnana phala moksha. So that example is not valid here. Why so? Purvapakshina pradarshitaha vriksha drishtanta asangataha. Yadyapi jalasechanam vrikshasya utpattau rakshane cha hetuhu, tathapi phalotpattau na hetuhu. Watering the plant is not the reason for the phala of the vriksha. Although vrikshotpatti and rakshana is done by jalasechana, it is not the hetu for phalotpatti. Tata hi vriddha yaha vrikshaha, tasya jalasechanam rakshanaya evana phalaya. Jalena pushtaha yaha vriksha sa phala heturiti satyam. It is agreeable that the vriksha which is nourished by watering, that vriksha will give phala. That vriksha will give phala. So vriksha will become phala hetu. But if you compare it with a vriddha yaha vrikshaha, tasya jalasechanam rakshanaya na phalaya. You go and water old trees, they can no longer give phala. Can they give phala? Even if you water, how much ever you water, the old trees which can no longer give fruits, they can just survive. They cannot give you phala. Had the jalasechana been karana for phala, then vriddha phala will also give you phala on watering. But what are you doing? You are watering the tree not for its utpatti, it is already utpanna. You are not watering the tree for phala because it cannot give phala. You are watering it for preservation of the tree. You just want the tree to survive. You do not want it to fall off or die away. Jalena pushta ya vriksha sa phala heturiti satyam natu jalasechanam phalotpattim prati hetuhu. However, watering this tree is not directly the cause of phalotpatti. Evam eva karmopasane jnanotpattau hetu bhavatah natu mokshe. Similarly is the case with jnana. Karma and upasana lead to jnana by giving chitta shuddhi. They make this buddhi antakkarana as an adhikrita adhisthana for jnanotpatti. As a karana for jnanotpatti or adhikarana for jnanotpatti. But they by themselves do not lead to moksha. Tasma jnanotpatte prag eva antakkaranasya shuddhaye chanchalya nivrittaye cha karmopasane anushtheye. Before this jnanotpatti, what is necessitated is karma for chitta shuddhi and upasana for chitta achanchalyam. Jnanotpatte anantaram moksha nimittan na te anushtheye. After the jnanotpatti, you do not need karma upasana. One should drop them and move on to shravana manana nididhyasana punah punaha. For nishtha, the dhyana which is needed is not upasana rupa, it is manana rupa or it is yoga rupa. It has nothing to do with karma and upasana which are prescribed by the shastra. And this is said in the Shastra also. Jnanotpatte purvam api antakkarane yavat paryantam malavikshepau staha tavat paryantam mevate anushteye. So you are the only one who will know how long do you need to do karma and upasana. because jnanotpatti is pratyaksha to you, it's aparoksha to you. So jnanotpatti purvam api antakarane yavat paryantam. So how long should one do that? After jnanotpatti, one should not follow karma and upasana. One need not follow karma and upasana. Then before that, how long should one do it? As long as there is mala in the chitta. This is also known to you pratyakshataya. So there is a catch 22 also. I mean, jnanotpatti can't take place without chitta shuddhi. And chitta shuddhi is possible through karma upasana. As long as you don't know that jnanotpatti has taken place, chitta is not known as shuddha. And you are not supposed to continue that. You don't need to continue karma upasana if the chitta is shuddha for jnanotpatti. So there is some dependency there. It is a little tricky situation before jnana. But after jnana, it is very clear. So pre-jnana also, he says jnanotpatte purvam api, even earlier, even if jnana has not taken place, if one is a mumukshu, mumukshu meaning only moksha ichchu, kevala mumukshu, not moksham api ichchu. One who is kevalam moksham ichchu, mokshasya ichchu, that moksha ichchu should drop karma upasana. Because it has fructified into the only desire remaining, that shows chitta shuddhi. So if the desire is not anything else, I don't want to keep my parents happy, my spouse happy, I don't want to keep the world happy, I don't want to become happy by anything else, by other means, I am happy on my own, then that is the only goal that I want, then there is no other dependency. I don't want name, fame, wealth, comforts, luxury. If I am okay with body sustaining by any which means, which are dharmika, of course, then I don't need to do karma upasana. I can walk out as a vividisha sannyasi. So even jnanotpatte purvam api antakkarane yavat paryanta mala vikshepa ustaha, in the antakkarana, as long as mala and vikshepa are there, meaning avarana and vikshepa are there, tavat paryantam evate anushteye, as soon as you know that you are not deha, you want to know the real Atma, you can drop off karma upasana if you do not have any other desire. Yasya antakranam shuddham nishchalam cha jatam sa jijnyasu shravana virodhini karma upasane tyaje deva. Because this karma and upasana will keep on increasing the dvaita bhava every time you do it. Everything will keep on making this, what has been said here as, this can be read it another way. Vidyate hridaya granthi. What is this hridaya granthi? It is said to be avidya granthi. However, if you look at that granthi, those who have, you know, tried to open up knots, not cut them, open knots. You see, it is difficult to open knots the more the knots are. So the more a person keeps on acting, the more are these knots formed in as hridaya granthi. So this is another way to look at it. As long as one keeps on doing this karma and upasana, it will keep on making the deha bhava drida, the tadatmya sambandha will become drida, the granthi becomes drida. Then what happens is that they become opposed to shravana. Shravana and karma upasana, we have seen earlier, jnana sadhana also, not jnana, jnana sadhana also is opposed to karma sadhana. Jnana and karma upasana have virodha, jnana sadhana and karma sadhana have virodha. You cannot have them together, therefore karma upasane tyaje deva. Why? Shravana virodhini karma upasane. Karma and upasana are shravana virodhi. This is shravana virodhi, shravana virodhini, shravana virodhini. This how? This will decline. This is napunsaka. Dual, like karma upasana. So karma upasana are two, therefore karma upasane, and they are shravana virodhini, they are opposed to shravana. vividisha sanyasam kuryad iti yavat. Therefore, the idea is that person should take to vividisha sanyasa for moksha. And this has been said in Shruti Smriti. Arukshor muner yogam karma karanam uchyate yoga arudasya tasyeva shamak karanam uchyate. Bhagavad Gita 6th chapter says that karma and upasana are karana for one who is arurukshuhu. Arudam ichchuhu. He wants to attain yoga. But after attaining yoga, yoga arudasya, one who has attained yoga, karma yoga, tasya eva shamak karanam uchyate. For karma yoga, for yoga, this yoga is leading from karma yoga to jnana yoga. The entire range is included there. Till then, one has to keep on doing karma. But as soon as one attains that chitta shuddhi, really, shama is sannyasa there. Because withdrawal of sense organs is not possible while being in the samsara. I know of people who talk about, you know, I am trying nididhyasana nishtha, but the person is driving the car. So he says that, you know, I am very scared because if I start inquiring into the Atma Tattva while driving, I don't know where I am headed, I can meet up with an accident. This is something that someone told me a few months back. I said, it is not possible. You cannot have jnana karma samuchaya. That samuchaya won't work. So shamak karanam uchyate, there shama is withdrawal of the sense organ. It is literal. It is not, you know, you cannot say that, oh, I am in the world and my mind is in the forest. It is all okay in the Shastras. These are Arthavadas. It is not practical. It is not possible even. Bhagavan Bhashyakara refutes that viewpoint also. In fact, in Bhagavad Gita, if you read the Bhashya, he has questioned the case of Janaka also. He gives concession there and then he says that we do not know whether Janaka took sannyasa later, or rather he says that we do not know when Janaka was continuing, he was a jnani or he was doing that for chitta shuddhi. He says that, he brings that viewpoint which was not in place there. So like Janaka, look at Janaka, says Krishna to Arjuna, and Bhagavan Bhashyakara says there, like Janaka, who may have been a jnani but who may have also been doing it for chitta shuddhi, we are not sure. So this is, he brings about a point in favor of refutation of jnana karma samuchaya. Jidnyasayam sampravruttaha nadriyet karma chodanam chittasya shantaye karma natu vastu upalabdhe. So vastu upalabdhi is not possible through karma, but it is for chitta shanti, chitta shuddhi. Chitta chanchalya is being talked about. Karma is also inclusive of upasana. Vastu siddhir vicharena nanyatha karma koti bhi tasmat karma na kurvanti yatayah paradarshinaha. What is this vastu siddhi? Vastu tantra. The dependency of jnana is not on anything else. Karma cannot change the way you cognize something. You cannot see a red pot as blue just by doing some karma or upasana. You cannot wish it away also. Vastu tantra, jnana is vastu tantra, it is dependent on the vastu. Similarly, this jnana, vastu siddhi, vicharena, you inquire into the swarupa. Can this pot be blue? It cannot be, it is red. So you inquire into it, if it rajju sarpasthane, you inquire into, can it be sarpa? It appears as sarpa. So vichara will tell you vastu. It is Rajju. Rajju is known as Rajju through Vichara, not through karma, not by hitting it away, not by wishing it away, not by upasana, meditating upon Sarpa as Rajju. That will not change the real Sarpa into Rajju. That will not take away the fake Sarpa also and bring about real Rajju. Real Rajju will always remain real. It will always remain Rajju. You just have that Vastu Siddhi through Vichara. Na anyata karma koti bhi. You do koti karmas also, crores of karmas will not bring about that vastu siddhi. Tasmat karma na kurvanti. That is why yatayaha, yatis, sannyasis do not do karma, because they are paradarshi. They have gone beyond that. They have vision of that which is beyond all this. Ityadi vachane. So I'll just finish this para, although we are running over time. Ityadi vachane bhyaha. Shamaha is sannyasa there. There are so many statements in Shruti and Smriti. Malam nama papam. This mala is papa, which will be an obstacle for jnanotpatti in the chitta. Tachya ashubha vasanaya hetuhu. This will keep on triggering ashubha raga. Yavat paryantam malam asti, tavat paryantam ashubha vasana asti. So one should know that as long you can, you cannot objectify papa directly, but by the result of papa which is there, and we all have punya and papa mixture, therefore there is shubha and ashubha vasana. If there is ashubha vasana, we know there is ashubha vasana. If we know that there is ashubha, then we know that chitta is not shuddha. Karma and upasana should definitely continue. They should not be dropped. It is very dangerous to drop karma and upasana. If the chitta is ashuddha, one will become a new Vedantin and one will lead to worse than the current status. It is not definitely leading to moksha. It is going to lead to adhogati really. Yada ashubha vasana no deti. But in case for a good period of time you know that your chitta is shuddha, by knowing that you don't have ashubha vasanas, and this is pratyaksha to each and everyone. Nobody else needs to know. Nobody else can tell you otherwise, and you cannot fool anyone else. So you should be true to yourself. When ashubha vasanas are there, continue with karma and upasana. If they go away, then malabhavaha nischayaha. Nischayaha. So you know that there is no mala, antakkaranasya shuddhi has taken place. Then antakkaranasya chanchalya ikagraye hi anubhava siddhe. And antakkaranas chanchalya and ekagra is anubhava siddha. You know whether your mind is wandering, nobody else knows that. Unless somebody is a siddha, that's a different story. But you yourself know that your mind is still or wandering. You know whether you are hearing me out or you don't know. Your mind is elsewhere. This is very clear to you. Therefore, anubhava siddha tasmad uttama jijnyasor vidushoho vishaye karma upasane nishprayojane. Karma and upasana has no use at all for a vidwan who is an uttama jijnyasu also. For an uttama vidnyasu or a vidwan, there is no necessity of karma upasana. In fact, they are shravana virodhi, has been said by sadhu. So we'll stop here. We'll continue the next part. Huh? Day after. Sukam nityam suprakasham vyapakam namurpe adhishthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drukyattva niruna param sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva annamattva neti me nischitamatihi. Om tat sat. Namaste.